Welcome back. Well, it's been 10 years since Emily Williams first grabbed our attention. It was back in 2005. The talented singer was runner-up on season 3 of Australian Idol. She left her mark thanks to her huge powerhouse vocals.
Following the program, Emily teamed up with fellow Idol contestants to form pop group Young Divas. The girls enjoyed huge success with their debut album. And when Jess Malloy joined in 2007, well, the hits just kept coming. So why don't you turn me loose, turn me loose, turn me
loose. I gotta do it my way. Since then, Emily has established herself as a successful solo artist and has just released her latest single, The Way It Is. And Emily joins us now live from Melbourne. Emily, welcome back to the show.
Oh, thank you so much, guys. Thank you for having me.
Pleasure. We're just looking at that Australian Idol vision. I can't believe it's been 10 years since then.
I can't believe it. It shocks me sometimes because I actually had my 21st birthday on the show. So if you think 10 years ago, obviously I'm turning 22. So it's been some time.
Ah, nice one, Emily. Of course, your friend Kate DeRouge went on to win that season. Did either of you have any idea of how much your lives would change?
We were, you know, I don't think any of us were prepared for the opportunities and the doors that were obviously open to us after the show. It was really, really hard, to be honest. But you know what? We took it by the stride, and we're still pushing to this day. So it was a great experience. We're happy for it.
We know she's had a bit of a rough time lately. She was arrested for driving under the influence. Are you still friends? Do you still chat?
Good old Kate. I saw her, I think, a month ago. I wish her well and all the best. I don't really know about the incident with the drink and driving. So wherever she is, I hope she can hear me. I love you and I miss you and call me.
She's been really open about her battle with addiction. Do you think it can be difficult to adjust to life after being thrust in the spotlight?
I think it's different for any artist to adjust, because we all, I guess for me, example, like I've got an amazing team and I've got an amazing family that obviously can put my head back into the right way. When you've got a good upbringing, I guess it's the morals that stick with you the older you get. So I think for me, that's kind of what happened for me, and I just stuck with those morals and I'm still here singing till this day.
Yeah, good for you. Emily, after Idol, you were part of the Young Divas lineup, and at the time, much the same as any group or any band, there were reports of suggesting that there was a bit of tension in the group. But what was it like at your end? What was it like for you?
Oh my goodness, well, think about it. You've got four girls in a group. Do you honestly think we're going to agree with everything? With every decision that was made for us, there was no way. We've all got different personalities and we all brought something different to the group. We all learnt off each other. So I'll be honest, we didn't agree with everything, but I think from those disagreements, we all learnt off each other.
Jess Malloy floated the idea last year of a potential reunion. What do you think? Is that something you'd be open to?
Oh, did she? Oh, okay. That would be fun. It's been a while since I've had a jam or a sing with those girls, so it would be fun. Yeah.
You've been focusing on a solo career for the last few years. Is it tough for independent artists to get noticed?
Well, I'll be honest. Compared to being signed to a label, it's more hard work, and you have to really, really want it, and really get yourself out there and work that behind off. To make sure that you can get what you need to obviously succeed.
Is it nice to have that freedom though now, Emily? You're not tied to the big machine anymore. You're doing it your way.
Yes, honestly, I couldn't be happier. Just the opportunities that has been thrown my way to obviously go overseas, get two top 10 hits over there and be able to tour. So it wasn't only a success for me here in Australia, but also overseas, so I'm really grateful.
Now, the new single, The Way It is about finding success in your own unique way. What do you hope that people take out of that? Obviously, it's something that you have learned.
Yes, I just hope people, you know, enjoy the song first. Hopefully people, know that, whatever you want to do, you're passionate in life, to always work hard, you can do it. Don't give up and keep pushing forward.
Do you regret anything, any path that you took in the past?
No, probably not. I don't regret anything because I think all the things that might have been a stumble for me was actually a learning block. So I learned more from obviously choices that I didn't agree with in the past. So it's kind of good.
Emily, what else can fans expect from you this year?
Well, this year I've got another single coming out. The album drops at the end of the year / beginning of the year. And then I guess I get back on the road and start touring again.
Good on you. Lovely to have you with us.
Emily, thank you so much for having me.
Best of luck.
Thank you.
Emily Williams' new single, The Way It is out now. For all of the details on her upcoming shows, just head across to the Daily Edition website.